since I was a teenager, and I was at school, I enjoyed the chapters about cell biology and things like DNA, and actually I read much more than was required by the biology teacher. And it was actually, I was taking part in biology Olympiads on those like national level. So I really enjoyed that actually. That sort of encouraged me to deepen my knowledge in biology. And then I joined a couple of extramural schools for school children. And we would go to university a couple of times a year and do various practicals and being instructed by professors and students. So at that time, I had quite a good, picture of what chemistry and other molecular sciences are about. And I thought that, that's definitely my career choice.
Right. The most difficult thing in science, I think, is coping with failing experiments. Because experiments actually, they fail in science all the time. And initially, when you just start in science, it seems like a such terrible thing. As maybe there's something wrong with me, I'm not talented enough. But in fact, that's not true, I think. And even if the experiment fails, it actually still gives you some useful information that a certain process doesn't happen in this way, and it happens in some other way. So Edison, Thomas Edison.
Yeah.
He didn't invent the light bulb from his first attempt, and it took him, maybe 3,000 attempts to reach a successful result. Instead of saying that he failed for 3,000 times, and only then he succeeded to invent the light bulb, he said that actually he invented 3,000 different ways of how not to invent the light bulb, and one way how to invent the light bulb. So I like this. So originally I'm from Lithuania, and I came to UK to do a PhD. I think it's really important actually to go abroad and meet new people, learn new skills, and broaden your sort of perspective so you can create a better strategy in your science. Why specifically UK? I just got a good scholarship to do a PhD in UK. But you could well have been some other country, and I don't mind really. That's another thing which I really love about science. That you get to travel quite a lot. Actually, you're going to the conferences, two, three conferences a year, and you meet new people, you see new places. That's really, really nice aspect of science.